Perfect. Now that our app is loaded, we are going to update it. So let's get real. The first thing we are going to build is a top bar, because with it, we are already going to be able to navigate to our different screens or different parts of the app. And if you remember well, it's just a box. Then each tab will be a separate page living its own life. So let's dive in. To find all the boxes we want, we have the palette here, the UI mobile elements. It's our candy box. There is everything we want here. So what we want is to make a tab bar. So I'm going to just put tab here. And I have three elements. I'm going to start by the tab container because we need a box to then put tab in it. So let's just drag tab container into our content here, into our page. And now we have our tabs container. And now that I have my first box inside, I'm going to put a bar. And that bar is going to be full of icons. And those icons are actually buttons. So again, a box into it. And in that tab, I can now put an icon. And as you can see, our tab bar already appeared with the icon ready. So all we have to do actually is duplicate that tab button. So we can do like copy and paste. Or we can simply just use a lot of tab button here, and there, and there, and icon in all of it. In the last tab, what I'm going to put is not an icon, it's going to be an avatar, like a small picture of a user. So it's already available in the candy box. So I just put my avatar item here, and then I put an image inside. All good. Okay, now we got everything we need. So let's see the last panel. I was hiding it. It's a property panel. Here, we only have plus icon. That's not what we want. Here, the first one, if I want to follow Instagram, I know it's a home icon. So I can just go and check. Is there home here? Here it is, home. And I just push enter. And now my icon is gonna update to be what I want. Perfect. Let's just do it for the other icon. And here it is. We already have our tab bar functional and pleasant. The last thing we need is a nice picture to show our avatar. So let's go and find it. I can just fetch it from Google directly because I'm a bit lazy. Okay, so this one looks perfect. Okay, let me just get the link here. Back in Convertigo, and let's just set the nice URL here. Okay. All good. All set. We got our buttons, but they aren't doing anything right now because we did not relate the tab button to a new page. So that's what we are going to do right now. By the way, our avatar is a bit big right now, but you'll see. We'll correct this. So now I need to create new pages just inside the folder pages. Pretty logical. So new, let's create a page. Okay, page, perfect. And let's name it the feed for the main screen feed. Okay, and we're just going to create new pages for all the cases we have. Okay, so now that we created all our different pages, we just are going to link that to the button, to each button. So here, I just have to go in my property panel and choose the right page. So the first button is for the feed page. So I just go there, click on that square and select page. Okay. And now I got the tab button page and I do the same for the rest of it. Okay, so now let's add a bit of content just to test it. So let's put content. and then text. Okay. And now we can see that when we navigate to the discovery tab, there is no text, but in the feed tab, there is. And the same for the others. So our tab bar and navigation is all set. We can go to the next step. Just after tab navigation, we'll see how we can navigate inside one tab to have effect, to use menu, to check settings and more.